It's me, Foundation Lips Tutorials, and I am back here with a new video for you guys. No, I am not wearing anything on my lips except for foundation today, but all for a very good reason, because today I'll be showing you the brand spankin' new Pat McGrath Matte Trans Lipsticks. And this one is really special to me because Pat McGrath is my idol. If you don't know who Pat McGrath is, she is the one who invented pretty much all the trends. She has done all the covers of all the magazines. She is, for pretty much most of the fashion shows, like the big fashion shows, the creative director behind the looks. She is the mother of makeup. So Pat McGrath has always been my number one inspiration. Like, her creativity is out of this world. So when I got the chance to film with her a couple of months ago to be sort of like a plus size model for her campaign, for a new launch that she was doing, it literally felt like working with my personal god. So it doesn't come as a surprise that I screamed really loudly when Pat asked me to come back for a second video focusing on the matte trans lipsticks. So a couple of weeks ago, I went back to New York City and filmed another campaign slash video with Pat and her team. Pat actually gifted me the matte trans lipsticks that day. And here I am today, pretty much just showcasing you the new colors and how they look on my lips and what I think of them and just all of that good stuff in a little playtime video. As always, my opinions are completely and 100% my own. If I do not like a color or I do not like the consistency, you'll be the first to know. I even told Pat her pink highlighter in the past has never been a huge favorite of mine, and it actually was an oh god no. So that kind of tells you that, you know, I'm not bullshitting you guys. So yeah, without any further ado, I think it's time to look at these pretty beautiful babies right here and try them on the lips. All right, so welcome to my face. I'm Jane Sim James, and this is Transformin. No, I'm kidding. Yes, the foundation lips will be gone in a little bit. So looking at these brand new lipsticks by Pat McGrath, first of all, the packaging is out of this world. It is luxurious, it is chic, it is high class, and just beautiful. Now, I'll tell you right off the bat, my favorite part about this entire collection, and this is what makes Pat a genius. As you can see, when you hold the bullet, the lips, the gold lips, are up front. And when creating this design, Pat told me that she always wanted the gold lips right up front when someone is applying the lipstick. So what she did is she had new machines made to do the following. Usually when you twist up a lipstick, it just twists up like this and the lipstick comes out. So if you twist the gold part of the lipstick, it comes out straight. So insane. All right, let me show you that again. So when you have the gold lips up front, twist the gold part, twist it, twist it, twisted, and the lipstick comes out straight. I do want to note though, because when I first opened these, I was like, oh my god, let me try that again. And I twisted the black part. When you twist the black part, it comes out naturally, but when you twist out the gold, it comes out like magic and you have the lips up front when you apply the lipstick. I think it's genius. The lipsticks are going to be sold in sets of three or in a set with all the colors plus as singles. So there's a set of three nudes, which is called Skin Show. It also comes with a bright set, and this one is called Color Blitz. And then the last set, it's all about the vampy dark colors, and this one is called Vicious Venoms. So enough talking about the lipsticks, let's get down to the action and actually apply them onto the lips. I'm going to be starting off with the nude set, and I'm going to be starting off with the color 1995. Usually when I do lipstick swatches on camera, I put a layer of foundation on because I have really pigmented lips myself, but a lot of you have told me that you're scared that that will alter like the finish or the application of the lipstick. So for today's video, I'm gonna take everything off my lips and just fill it in over a bare lip. And since my lips are so pigmented, this will right off the bat tell you if the lipstick is pigmented or not. All right, foundation off, time to apply the first color. So that is my top lip done. And what I can tell is that the formula is really, really thin, but packed with pigment. So So this is what 1995 looks like on me. It's definitely one of those my lips, but better shades. It resembles my natural lip color a lot. It's just a little bit more brown and muted. I totally dig colors like this on the lips. They're natural and nude, but it still gives the lips some sass. So I really like this color. And what's so weird about this lipstick is that it feels really thin, like it barely feels like you're wearing anything, but it's packed with color intensity. So yeah. Next color is Omi, inspired by Naomi Campbell. And here is what Omi looks like on me. It's more of a red nude neutral. I personally myself think it looks bomb with this eye look right here and the entire look going on. So this is a more vibrant nude color. And formula and texture wise, it's just the same as 1995. It is a little bit creamier, and you can tell by the little bit of extra shine on the lips when finished. So this one is a little creamier. So beautiful nonetheless. Next in line is Flesh 3. And this to me looks like a straight up dark reddish burgundy color. This by no means will be a nude on my skin tone, but on deeper complexions, this can be phenomenal as a nude. Pigment. Honestly, the pigment on these are just insane. One swipe. As I kind of predicted, this is a very vampy, dark, burgundy, reddish color on me. I love this. I love this for fall, for winter, for nights out. Also, as I'm taking them off, I see no staining. That's my natural lip color. So I budged up the line of my foundation a little bit. So I'm gonna go in with a little bit of concealer and just kind of fade the lines. Oh, I love this so much more. I love this so much more. I feel like whenever I put lipstick over top of really nude lips, it's just gonna pop. No, we can't do it. We can't, no, go away. Let's go over to the bright side. Gonna start with this one, Elson, which is a beautiful crimson red. Whoa. It just glides on. I mean, it's honestly swipe, swipe, done. It's so packed with pigment. Trust me, I wanna be critical on these lipsticks. I wanna be critical and give you parts of it that I don't like. The only reason for now that I can think of you not liking this lipstick is because you do not like lipstick. Baby, it looks like Christmas on my face. Isn't this the classic Christmas makeup look? A little bit of glitter, neutral smoky eye, red lips. All I need is like Christmas lights in the backdrop, so. Okay, here we have Fool Panic, which is a bright ass fuchsia. It looks a little bit more red on me than I initially expected, but still a very fun party color. I know some of you are gonna ask, like, why are you acting so surprised about the formula and like the colors and the consistency? I only wore 3 colors for the video with Pat, and I didn't wear the others. My lips were done by Pat herself, or her amazing, amazing makeup artist, Adam. So I didn't get to play with them myself, actually applying them onto my lips myself. So hence why I'm loving this experience and loving seeing all these colors. Okay, last in line, Obsessed, with an exclamation point at the end. Oh, I love this color so much. It brings me back to that day. It reminds me of Lady Danger by MAC in color a lot. And I think this is one of those perfect summer colors to really, you know, get that sun on your body. And I think this is one of those colors that looks amazing on fair skin tones, medium, what's in between, dark, deep, deep dark, the deepest of dark. It looks good on everybody. And it's gone. They go on beautifully. They go off beautifully without staining. It's all right, time for the dark colors. Now, I feel like we're finally gonna hit a critical point of the video because if there's one thing that a lot of brands do wrong, it's dark, vampy colors. They always go like, you need 2 coats or 16. You need to wear a lip liner underneath, please. Brands always ask us to do more for it because they're hard. They're insanely hard to nail and like, they're hard to apply. So the first color I'm gonna go in with is Antidote, and this is a beautiful purple. Okay, moment of truth, finally a critical point. Why are these so good? Okay, so we finally have found one color that's not completely opaque like the others in one go. So this does need a second swipe. Once it's on, it's beautiful and purple and intense, but this one does need a little bit more of action going over top. So we have finally found a flaw, a feedback point in Antidote that it is just the smidgest, tiniest bit less pigmented than the other ones. Here we have Deep Void, and oh my God, is that black? It looks like a very cool satin, like suede, very purple, like deep dark, but it's pretty much black. No, it's not black on the lips. It's a very deep, deep, deep dark purple. Oh, wow, suddenly this video got so emo. I definitely notice a difference compared to the others, and it's even creamier than Omi, and I don't remember what other color that was, but it's even creamier than that. And with this one, I see a little bit, actually, let me finish this up before I judge. This one is definitely the creamiest. I do see a little breakdown of pigment right at the edge of the lip. I feel like this one is a little too creamy for the color. This is the only one I am a little bit afraid of running or moving, whereas with the others, it's thin and light and satiny matte, where I feel like it's secure enough for a lipstick, but this one I feel like eventually it's gonna go places. It's my lip color again. It's crazy how these do not stay. Okay, last one of the bunch. The 9th color is McMenemy. I have no idea what that means. And this one is my favorite of the dark set. I feel like if there's one, let me just save this until my end conclusion. It's less of that creaminess that we just had with Deep Void. I freaking love this color. It looks really fun. Okay, so here we are. And I just put on Obsessed again because I think Obsessed is my favorite color because I'm obsessed. So overall, when I look at these lipsticks, I see beautiful packaging, very forward and innovative thinking by getting the lipstick bullet up straight up so you have the lips always up front when applying the lipstick. I know I said this like a million times in this video already, but again, the formula on this one is like pure lipstick magic. It's absolutely non-drying on the lips, and after swatching all 9 of them, my lips feel fine. Trust me, when I have to swatch 9 Kylie Cosmetics liquid lipsticks, my lips will literally fall off and to never be seen again. Now, here are a couple of things that could make or break your decision to buy these or try these or not. In all honesty, I think that Deep Void was the weakest contender out of the bunch, with Antidote being a runner-up for that title. All others are creamy, intense, and super fun to work with. Another thing that's crucial is that these are high-end lipsticks. Now, I am not able to look into your wallet or look into your lifestyle, but singles retail for $38. Now, that is a lot of money for lipstick. money that I am willing to spend on this lipstick, because this is truly, and I'm not bullshitting you right now, this is truly one of the best lipstick formulas I've ever tried in my life. But $38 is a lot of money for lipstick, and I'll let you be the judge of that. If you think that is too much, you think that is too much. If you think that is worth it, you think that is worth it. Everyone is so personal when it comes to high-end makeup or luxury makeup, and everyone is different. Some stick to drugstore, some stick to high-end, and I will let you be the judge of that. Me personally, I think it's well worth it. Now with that said, Trios retail for $95, and if you want all the lipsticks in one bundle, you will pay $275. So that is for all of them. So overall, if you ask me, these are an insane recommendation. They are a luxury gift, and they are packed with lipstick magic. I am pretty much in love with these. So these babies right here go in pre-sale tomorrow on papmcgrath.com. They are available July 19th at papmcgrath.com. So that's no more pre-sale. They'll be available at papmcgrath.com 19th. Plus I know that they will be available at Sephora like always, because Pat works with Sephora. And I think that's all you need to know about the Match Trans lipsticks. First of all, what do you think? Let me know in the comment section down below. Sound off, tell me your raw opinion, give it to me. As always, if you enjoyed watching this video, then please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell to get a notification every time I upload. So when I upload, you get like a brrr. There's me. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today and joining this playtime video. And again, let me know in the comment section down below what you think, and hopefully I will see you guys on the next one.